What's up, zombie slayers? This is KJ48 and welcome back to my 7 days of die single player let's play. This is episode 4, and yesterday I walked home all the way back to my base. There's some pretty cool buildings over here that I'm gonna want to explore at some point, but I came home to my base, I collected a bunch of wood, I collected some stone, I collected some clay, and we're gonna be doing I don't normally record the nights, but we're gonna be doing some interesting building here, so I figured you'd want to be in on this. First of all, you notice I'm upgrading the floor to the second level of wood. Well, there's a reason for that, and we're going to get into it in a moment, but let me get started here for now. All right, so we just need a torch up on the wall right here. Actually, let's put another wall down. That's going to be a proper wall. Put a torch right there. Now you guys can see just fine. All right, what we're going to do is we're looking to make the forge now. In order to make the forge, we're going to need the bellows. All right, we need short iron pipe. Yeah, I might not have enough of that. How many did it say I needed? More than one. Oh, I only need one. Wow, that's pretty good that I only need one short iron pipe, so that's good. We need the animal hide. And there we go, we got some bellows. We're gonna make the bellows so we can make the forge. I also did some a little bit of building below, right here. I knocked out the stairs. I also plugged up the doors below, and there's a ladder coming up here. I'll show you tomorrow morning really what I did. Zombies are attracted to doors for some reason in this game, so you want to block up the doors, anytime you can. As a matter of fact, this needs to be upgraded as well. There we go. Okay. Alright, so now we got the bellows, we will look at the forge. What do we need for the forge? We need another short iron pipe. Gosh darn it, I know where I can get a short iron pipe if I had a wrench. You can get them from here. You could get short iron pipes from breaking a toilet, I believe. So let's come on down here. I know this is a little dark. Let's put some light up down here for you guys. The inside of this place is relatively safe. Like I said, I blocked up the door here. I started putting down some spikes out there, but not a lot. Oh, I also started a mine. So you can see right there. Nothing down there yet. I just started it. Okay, so where's the toilet? There's the toilet. So we break this up, and this should give us a pipe. There you go. So let's go ahead and make our first forge. Beautiful. And we just need to start feeding stuff into it. Iron and clay, mostly. I don't have a lot of clay left over, but it'd be enough to get like a pickaxe. I'd really like to get a pickaxe. Alright, so while that's doing its thing, we're also going to go ahead and make some more frames. I'm going to build a little bit of a living area up here. Is 24 too much? Nah, 24 is not too much. I'm going to build like a little bit of a living quarters up here. So first things first, we're going to go ahead and upgrade the wood. Now, I mentioned I'm upgrading this wood, alright? And not really for a good reason, apparently. Well, no, it is for a good reason. I'm going to show you why. If you look at the skill menu here, one of the first things I'm going to want to go for is going to be the construction tools. No, not construction tools. Wait, what am I looking for here? Construction tools, smithing. Oh, I'm looking for the workbench and the concrete mixing. Yeah. Okay, in order to get the workbench, my construction tools has to be 20. In order to get the concrete mixing, I can make the concrete mixer. That's what I want to do for you guys. And I'm going to need construction tools up to 20 for that. I'm also going to want to unlock steel smithing, which construction tools need to be 40. And wait a minute, concrete mixing. Unlocks the ability to make concrete and the cement mixer. Oh, so I thought the cement mixer and the concrete thing would be separate, but they're together. Once you unlock concrete, you get the ability to make the mixer as well. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but that's not reinforced concrete, is it? Recipe, concrete mix, cement, rebar frame, rebar ramp. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that gives you everything you need. Yeah, so anyway, I'm trying to get my construction tools up for that stuff. So, the upgrading stuff is a good way to get your construction tools up. So that's what I'm doing. Basically, they want you to build stuff, so. Alright, so with that done, we will All right, so that stuff's all done. Let's drop some stuff off. I started getting cold, so I take off the glasses and the cowboy hat. Both have negative insulation, so they make you cold. We got to put down the forge somewhere. Let's decide where we're going to put down the forge. I guess I don't normally like to put the forge and the campfire on wooden surfaces, but, you know, got to do what you got to do. All right, so let's put this stuff away. Let's put this over there. Let's put that. That stays over there. You guys are good right there. Let's put the chairs in there. The food away. Food should have went away a while ago, actually. It makes you smell. We're going to dump this stuff up here. And I guess that's it. Let's go ahead. ABC. Always be crafting. Stone axes. What are we missing? Plant fibers. We put those away. And stone axes. There we go. Now I need to decide where I'm going to put the forge. See, I want to put it right here, but that's going to mess this up when I pick that up. Eh, I guess it doesn't matter. Let's put it right here. Right next to the bed. It'll keep me warm. Why not? Alright, so now we got to start feeding stuff into the forge. So we're going to have to feed clay into the forge and iron. Is that all the iron I have? I don't believe I see any more iron in there. Is there any reason not to feed all the scrap iron into the forge? I could use some for spikes. I'm just going to feed half of it into the forge for now. And I always use wood for the forge. And there we go. Now the forge is going to call in screamers. So you know what? I'm only going to do enough for a pickaxe. Oh yeah, I need forged iron. So how much forged iron do I need for the pickaxe? 5. We only want this thing. Oh, we need a cooking pot too. So we need. Oh, okay. So you use scrap iron for the cooking pot. Interesting. And 5 clay. Wait a minute. I'm confused. It says we. Why can't we make it? Oh, because you need an anvil. Okay. It's been a while, guys. It's been a while. So we need 45 for that. And 20 clay. I don't know. I don't know why it's not making it. Give me a second. Clear out some inventory room. There we go. Okay. Anvil. Okay, we need to make the anvil. We need 200 iron. I was reading that wrong. Okay. I'm only going to do enough to make a pickaxe, and I'm going to shut this thing off because I do not want screamers coming in on me. As a matter of fact, it might be a good time to start building this base up. So if they do get called in, they at least don't see me. It's going to be very cozy up here, by the way. This thing needs to get out of here. Usually you want to take this apart with a wrench. I don't have a wrench, though, so... Okay, I do not have enough clay to get the cooking pot, so I'm just going to get some forged iron. And that'll be it for that. This is all done. We got to get this stuff out of here. We got to build this up properly. Alright, let's... That'll be enough. We'll leave the rest of it like that. We'll get the forged iron. And then we will be done with that forge, and we're going to turn it off. For those of you new players who don't know what's going on right now, there is a system in the game called the heat map. It has nothing to do with temperature. It has to do with, what's the word I'm looking for? It has to do with, like... It has to do with, like, activity in the area. Basically, what'll happen is once the heat, doing certain activities, I think most activities actually, will raise the heat in the area, and the forge is a big one. The forge really raises the heat in the area. And what'll happen is once the heat gets up to a certain level, it'll send in a screamer. And the screamer will come in looking to see what's going on. If the screamer sees you, she will then call in a horde. And it's a pretty nasty horde. It's something I want to avoid at all costs. The way to defend against it is fairly simple. You just, you simply make a, actually, I don't even know if I want windows here, because that's how she'll see me. Anyway, the defense against it is pretty simple. You just put spikes around your base. She'll eventually walk towards where the forge is and impale herself on your base. But while she's doing that, you also want to make sure she doesn't see you. All right, so I should be able to make myself a good iron pickaxe now. And we will be able to really start the mine. I'm trying to think how I want to do this. Yeah, let's do that, like that. That, like that. We're going to need a door. I just leveled up again. I think the first thing I want to... What is my construction skill at, anyway? I think the first thing I actually want to go for is Quality Joe. Because the first Quality Joe only takes 10 points. And, yeah, I think I'm going to go for the first Quality Joe first. Basically, that's going to give anything I find loot quality of plus 25. And then in order for me to get the next level quality jar, I have to get scavenging up to 30, which takes forever. So, probably won't get the next one for quite a long time. Alright, so now that that's done, let's start upgrading. This will hopefully level my construction, and then I can see where I'm at. I think I'm around 13 or something. Alright, come on. There we go. Ooh, 16. Nice. So once we get to 20, then we can make the, I think we can cement at 20. We're gonna have to start really looting hardcore, though. Hear that music? That means the zombies are no longer running. Okay. Should we actually get a better axe, too? We can. No, we can't. We don't have enough clay. We don't have enough clay for 5 of these. So, let's go ahead and get some more clay. Because I would like to get an axe before we actually go out. Stone shovel. We need the plant fibers. We don't have any. We also need rocks. We don't have any of that. We got a lot of work to do. Alright, let's just put this door in quickly, and then we're going to go out and start getting some clay. I'll show you where my clay deposit is. There we go. Whoa! Alright, let me show you what I've been doing down here on the outside. Okay, so this is the outside. Put a couple spikes around here, you know, just kind of getting ready. Getting ready for, you know, any problems. We're almost definitely going to spend day 21 here. We've got to get a lot more woodlog spikes. Should probably just place these down now. I'll probably place these these big spikes, and then I'll place the small ones behind them. I'm not going to be able to attack this stuff from the top, which is going to be bad, but... The 7-day horde is probably not going to be very active on my part. I'm probably just going to be standing up there, just waiting for it to go through. Maybe I won't even record it. I don't know. Because I really don't have what I need to fight it. I need more arrows. You know what? I can actually make more arrows, can't I? Yeah, let's go see if we can make more arrows while we're waiting. Or while we're out there harvesting and stuff. Feathers. No feathers, huh, guys? Do you guys see any feathers? I don't. Let's eat that. Let's eat some food. And drink. Man, we've been neglecting our drink. Crap. Well, we do have a lake next to us, but we don't have any way to cook this stuff. You know what we gotta do? We gotta stop breaking up the cans for now. We might have to actually drink some water out of, Nope, can't eat anymore. We might have to actually drink some water out of some cans. Or we could just do this. Let's take these vitamins. I don't need this just yet. Well, we might as well fill that. Put the bones away, put that away. We don't need the ladders. It's pretty good. Alright, I came up here for feathers and I didn't even... I don't see any feathers, guys, do you? Yep, there they are. I knew there was some in there. Not a lot, though. We're going to have to definitely look for some more bird's nests for show. I'm never thinking about bird's nests, you know? Alright, so I'm gonna show you guys a trick. If you have vitamins, they cure dysentery. So if you're in a position like me and you don't have a ton of water and water's kind of an issue, what you can do is you can go on down to the old watering hole and drink up. No, don't punch it. Right click the drink. And just drink till you're full. And then take the vitamins. There you go. Why am I warm? Like, why do I have the hot coffee thing? Is that from the water I just drank? It's out of a lake. How is it? Whatever. All right, we're gonna go loot and do some exploring. We're also gonna fill these jars. And we're gonna go do some exploring. We're gonna look for birds' nests, and we're gonna look for loot. On the way back, I purposely didn't loot anything because I don't like looting off camera. I like for you guys to see as much looting as possible. Every once in a while, I might loot off camera, but it's very rare. You know what we're also going to need? We're going to need some stone. We're going to need some boulders. Keep a lookout for some boulders. I don't know. I'm talking to myself, obviously. Oh, look at these bridges. So these bridges used to collapse all the time, but they don't collapse anymore. Here we go. Yeah, pickaxe for days, people. Love these things. And this ain't even the steel one. This is just a crappy old pickaxe. Well, relatively, I mean. I kind of like it. what did I need that stone for? Oh yeah, a shovel. Stone shovel. We also need some plant fibers. Getting plant fibers is the most boring goddamn thing ever. I'll probably take some time off camera and get quite a lot of them. Hello? Yes. Yeah. So these things don't collapse, huh? That's what I was told. Somebody said if you build on them, they'll collapse, though. Oh, here we go. Okay. Alright. Someone said that, like, I'm looking for a bird's nest, but I'm sprinting everywhere. It's a good point. But I'm always in a hurry, you know, I just want to get places. But I shouldn't sprint as much. It's hard for a Let's Player, you know, like I'm trying to be thorough and get everything right, but I'm also trying to entertain. And usually entertainment's quick. It's not like, you know, waiting around a long time for stuff. You know what? We're here. Let's just get this really quick. We won't get too much. Always finish out the part you're digging, because you get the bonus at the end. By the way, they fixed the stamina drain on the shovels. You lose as much stamina while shoveling than doing everything else you do. Which is, you know, thank the Lord. By the way, there's a building over here. I passed the building that was like the building I stayed in off of 12. And it did have a forge in it, but it's not that hard to make a forge, so I wasn't really concerned. Alright, should we fight these guys? Oh, that's the thing over there, see that? It's pretty cool. Should we fight these guys? Yeah, I think we should. I missed him. There we go. I hate it when you pull back the bow and the bow gets in the way of your aim. It doesn't do it that often, but it's annoying when it does. You're a tough one, aren't you? But you're gonna go down just like the rest. Alright, we gotta loot. Damn it. Oh, come on. Drop something, you cheap bastards. Oh, seriously? God, they barely had anything for me. Oh well. Is that the burnt version, or I can't tell? Yeah, it's a burnt version. Yeah, no, it's not the burnt version. This is the one I passed. See, there's the forge. And here's the bookcase. Pfft, nothing in it. Every time I open a bookcase and there's nothing in it, a piece of my soul dies. I mean, they're somewhat rare, you know? Not rare, actually uncommon. So it's important to loot every one of these cupboards because I'm trying to get my scavenging skill up. Personally, I would be happy to let these go by, but scavenging skill is important. If you want to get that second quality Joe. I was told that these blood draw kits now disappear after use. Let's see. Nope. It's still there. Medicine, science, health. Yep, no, it's still there. So, I don't know if like there's only a certain amount of blood you can get from the blood draw kits, if there's a certain amount of uses for it, but I just used it once and it didn't disappear, so. Take that for what you will. Alright, can we wear any of this? Yes, we can wear that. Scrap. I'm not gonna wear any of this stuff because it's hot. Okay, done with this. Done with this house. Alright. Now let's look at this building over here, then we'll go across the water and look at that building over there. And we got some more zombies to kill. I'm gonna hold on to these empty cans for the time being, because until we find a cooking pot, it's gonna be the only way for us to get water, clean water. Missed. Hit. Man, you didn't even swing, bro. Oh, now look at you. Kerr thump. Right on his back. I love that sound when the zombies fall. You guys notice that sound when the zombies fall? I think it's awesome. Great. Oh, what's this? Oh, it's a damn... Oh, what? These are on fire now? Should I pick up one that's on fire? Okay. That's kind of weird. I didn't know if I should do that or not. Why do I care about gunpowder? I don't know. Blueberry seeds. I already have blueberries, so... You know what? 5 gunpowder. Let's hold on to it. We'll see. Maybe the game's going to drop more gunpowder and make it worth it for me to pick it up. Maybe I can make a blunderbuss or something. This is a nice place. Yeah, well, you know, considering. Knock, knock. I come prepared with the pickaxe, bro. Nothing. Kind of nothing. Nothing. There we go, cooking pot. Beautiful. Now we can scrap these. Alright, let's get on the other side. See what's over there. That's like an island over there, right? It'd be pretty cool if there was no zombies on that island at all. Although zombies can walk underwater, so there'd be no real reason for there not to be any zombies over there. But that's a new area for me, at least. I don't know if that's new to Alpha 14, or if that was put in before. Because, like I said, I haven't played Nav's game, like, on a Let's Play in over a year. Well over a year. Should be looking for bird's nest. Keep forgetting. We gotta kill Fatty Fat Fat up there. Tubby Fat Fat douchebag. Alright, hold off. This is gonna go a little bit longer. Oh, that's pretty cool. I like this town. You want to pick up those barrels because the zombies will blow them up. I think it's a mistake. Like, they just beat on them without really meaning to, obviously, but... this is not a good place to fight. What? What? Right through her head. Come on. Come on, tons of fun. Wow. I'm gonna melee your ass. Down you go, my friend. You know what? There's some corpses over here that are gonna gore up if we don't get them. Die already. Sheesh. Alright, is there anything I can get rid of? We could scrap that. We'll hold on to these two for now. I don't know why these aren't stacking. They only stack in three now. That's equipped? I can equip the burning barrel? I don't think I should do that. That doesn't sound like a good idea. Just saying. Okay. What else can I do? I can make more arrows. I could fill up more jars. Great, my guy's cold now that I got rid of all those warm clothes. Is there anything else I can get rid of? I could probably just use this note, it's annoying. I know it's time, but I'm never gonna finish it, it doesn't matter. I'll finish it eventually, but... whoa, look at that dirt. There we go. Can we wear that from here? No. We can take it and then wear it. Take it and then scrap it, take it and scrap it. I thought I just read this note. What the hell? There we go. Oh, so the rabbit one is not timed. Good. I gotta kill 5 rabbits. Damn, that's gonna take forever. You know what? I'm sorry to do this, Scree Girl, but I need the inventory room. And I'm gonna get rid of the gunpowder. Got more vitamins, that's cool. Okay, forget it. Where's the gunpowder? Every time I go to get rid of the gunpowder, I loot more gunpowder. The game is trying to tell me something, but I don't know what it is. Could it be grabbed? By the way, it's raining. How about that? That's pretty cool. Ooh, this one's gonna be hard to get into. Can we get in from the back easier? Oh shoot, I forgot my timer went off quite a while ago. Alright guys, we're gonna call this one here. Long video is long. Thanks for watching. That's gonna be it for episode 4. We'll see you next time for episode 5. Till then, take it easy.